Hello friends, in this short video I'm going to talk about tachypnea in newborns. Now tachypnea is a very common condition. Most of the time it occurs because of respiratory problems. And before I dive into the cause of tachypnea, please keep it in mind that tachypnea means increase in the respiratory rates. So the normal newborns have got a respiratory rate which can vary anywhere between 30 to 60 breaths per minute. But if a newborn has a consistent breath rate or respiratory rate above 60 breaths per minute, we would call it tachypnea. So the cutoff level for the neonates is 60 breaths per minute. So if any baby who has got a respiratory rate of more than 60, that would be classified as a tachypnea. Now, the most common cause of tachypnea is respiratory problems. A variety of respiratory problems of the newborns can give them tachypnea. And it's easy to diagnose because in most of the cases you will have certain signs in the chest, like it could be crabs, it could be wheezing, there might be increased work of breathing. But in this short video I want to focus on the causes of tachypnea when the rest of the examination is negative. So in other words, I would be focusing on isolated tachypnea. So isolated tachypnea means that the newborn has got a respiratory rate of greater than 60 breaths per minute, but he hasn't got any other signs. Like if you auscultate the chest is perfectly clear to auscultation. It might be associated with mild increase in work of breathing, like mild subcostal and substernal recessions. It might be associated with tachycardia or might not be associated with tachycardia. So remember, a child who has got a baby who has got an isolated tachypnea and has got tachycardia with it, but the chest itself is clear to auscultation. Remember, the first thing could be heart failure. So a baby who has got heart failure, and again, heart failure can be because of a variety of condition, mostly congenital heart problems. So a congenital heart problem or any other problem that leads to heart failure, the baby would be having isolated tachypnea along with tachycardia. In the initial stages, the tachycardia might not be that much significant, but later on, the later stages, the tachycardia obviously becomes quite significant. Another reason for isolated tachypnea in absence of tachycardia and other signs is acidosis. So a baby who is acidotic, whether it's respiratory acidosis or more commonly metabolic acidosis, because of any reason, that might be sepsis, that might be underlying metabolic condition, or that might be a congenital heart problem. If that leads to acidosis, that would lead to isolated tachypnea without any other chest findings. The third important cause of isolated tachypnea, where the chest is normal, might be a missed congenital heart disease. And one of the common missed congenital heart disease which can give you isolated tachypnea is coarctation of aorta. So coarctation of aorta is a condition in which part of the aorta is stenosed, and most of the lesions are proximal to the ductus arteriosus. So by the time the ductus arteriosus closes, then there is a gap in the perfusion at the upper part of the body and the lower part of the body. So the lower part of the body doesn't get enough oxygenated blood, and obviously that would lead to acidosis, that can lead to shock, that can lead to signs of heart failure, and that can lead to isolated tachypnea as well. So the three common causes of isolated tachypnea in absence of other findings, especially when the chest is clear to auscultation: number one is heart failure, number two it's acidosis, number three coarctation of aorta. And not to miss, in a child who has been born by a cesarean section, transient tachypnea of the newborn is a temporary condition which can happen in a few hours after the delivery, usually C-section, and it's because the baby is born very quickly, the lungs have not been molded by passing through the birth canal, so there has been a bit of fluid in the lungs which takes a bit of time to clear up, and that retention of fluid inside the lung can give you tachypnea for a few hours. As the fluid is reabsorbed, that tachypnea is resolved. So heart failure, acidosis, a missed congenital heart disease, especially coarctation of aorta, and transient tachypnea of the newborn are important differentials for isolated tachypnea or isolated increase in respiratory rate in the neonate. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.